The publication of the Watson School to Birmingham, 1963, made a real difference in my life, complete difference in my life. For the first time, I was doing something that I enjoyed doing. I was successful at it. I was able to, with the success came financial success too. So I was able to buy things that before I wasn't able to buy. And I discovered that there's just nothing in the world like doing something that you enjoy and being able to make a living at it. So the Watson School to Birmingham has, I've said this a lot of times, has always been my favorite book. One of the reasons was it got me, I was working in a warehouse at the time. And because of that book, I don't work in a warehouse anymore. One of the ways I get through life is by having very low expectations. That way you don't get nasty surprises. So when the book did well and it started to win awards, I go into kind of a shell, I think, and you know, it's great to hear these things, but I don't really buy them. And I think that's a good protective mechanism, because bad things that you hear as well, you don't really buy them. You know, you realize, okay, that's good to hear something like that. I didn't really realize how well the Watsons was doing, because you're with your royalty period, you know, you're like a year behind from what the sales are. So it wasn't until then, but I thought I was doing really well when I got a call from a principal in Michigan who had read the book, and I was working in a warehouse unloading trucks at the time, and he said that he wanted me to come speak. And I thought, okay, you want me to come speak? And he said, and we don't have a lot of money to pay you. I thought, okay, you know, 20 bucks, I'll be there. But he said, we have $300. And I remember almost dropping the phone, $300? I said, yeah, okay, I'll be there. Because I was making $300 a week in the warehouse.